Hello, and welcome to HCAM News Focus. Tom Nappy at the anchor desk to keep you up to date with what's happening in Hopkinton. On this edition of HCAM News Focus, we'll focus on the Hopkinton Hillers girls volleyball team, who for the second season in the past 3 years brought home a Division II state championship. Here are some of the highlights of the terrific 2016 championship season.
Yeah, so we both started playing volleyball in eighth grade, and we both got called up for the tournament team as sophomores. So we were part of the state championship year. So it was a really good opportunity, and yeah, we love playing volleyball.
Last year, the Hillers girls volleyball team came off of winning the Division II state title and advanced to the semifinals before losing at a tough Westboro team. Westboro went on last season to lose in the state finals against Notre Dame High School. The Hillers lost a good amount of experienced players to graduation last year, but this season featured two multi-sport athlete captains and a strong athletic team.
So we were both chosen captains this year. So our role is to get everyone hyped up and lead the team, make sure everything's organized, and yeah. So.
All right, how's the team looking this year?
Considering that we've only been playing for a few days and the amount of scrimmages and time we've put in, we're looking really great, and we've set a lot of high goals this year to possibly go to the state, be state champs again.
All right, what are some of the drills you've been working on here in these practices?
Yeah, we've done a lot of scrimmaging so far, so just seeing different opponents and trying to figure some stuff out. But so we haven't had many actual practices, but in practice we're definitely working on all coverages and hitting and everything to make sure that we're ready for our big game against Ashland on Wednesday.
Excellent. And I understand some young players on the team. How's the team chemistry going so far?
It's going awesome. We do a lot of stuff outside of the gym, like going out to eat and stuff, so our bonding's going really well.
And we're headed to the Cape this weekend for a long weekend sleepover thing, so that will be a really good bonding experience. But so far, very, very good.
Nice way to kick off the season.
Yes, definitely.
Hey guys, this is the 2016 varsity volleyball team.
We challenge all our school fans to come to our games. All our games, our first home game is Wednesday, so be there.
6:30.
Shout out to the Hopkinton High School band. We'd hope to see you at one of our games this season. We love you.
Yeah. And three, two, one.
Hillers hurrah!
They are off to an excellent start as well. 7-1 overall for the volleyball squad. And they started off with a pair of wins. They opened up the season with a shutout of Ashland, followed that up with a shutout of Millis. Then they lost to Barnstable. But then, two more shutouts for Hillers Volleyball as they took down Holliston and Bellingham 3-0. And then they beat Medfield 3-1. And then another shutout over Westwood 3-0 for Hillers Volleyball. And they also followed that up with a shutout over Algonquin 3-0. Hillers Volleyball 7-1 on the season. Off to a great start for Hillers Fall Sports so far.
During the national anthem, there's only 11 of them there.
Yep. Yeah, it's the smallest team Margie's had. And she said, I was talking to her before the match, she said she likes the chemistry and the makeup of this team. And
sure.
The girls have had three scrimmages so far, so she's liked the way that they've played.
On Friday, October 14th, the Hillers volleyball team sported pink jerseys as they hosted Bellingham in the annual Dig Pink matchup to support the Side Out Foundation and the fight against breast cancer. Peyton Weber scored the 24th Hillers point off the serve as the Hillers took the first set 25-9. In the second set, a nice defensive hit by Amanda Gilbert helps the Hillers add their 19th point and take the 19-4 lead. They never look back as they take the frame 25-5. In the third set, freshman Peyton Weber strikes again as she gets a good back hit to set up Rachel Zale to make it 24-11 Hillers in the third set. Hillers followed up with a point after to take the set and sweep the match. That was the Hillers' seventh sweep in a row. They have since increased it to 8 sweeps in a row as they swept Westwood on Wednesday, October 19th to improve to 13-1 overall. The playoff-bound Hillers have 5 matches left during the regular season. Hillers Volleyball won their first two playoff games and has advanced to the sectional championship to take on Canton. In the first round, the Hillers defeated Medway by way of the sweep, and then in the second round, they battled a tough Westboro team. Third straight season, Westboro and Hopkinton met in the playoffs. The Hillers won the first two sets. Westboro took the third and gave the Hillers a run for their money in the fourth. The Hillers took the 3-1 victory and continue on in postseason play. Hopkinton High School defeated Canton by way of the sweep to claim the Division II Central Sectional Final. HCAM's Mike Terosian caught up with Hillers head coach Margie Grabmeier and some of the Hillers players after the victory.
All right. So, you just got yourself a Central Division II championship. What do you think?
Awesome. Words can't even describe this feeling. I'm so proud of the team and the effort that we put in this year.
And what's next? You got a big game coming up on the 16th.
Oh, yeah. We're just going to put a lot of effort and just keep playing the way we do.
All right, so you're going to have a little fun tonight and then back to work tomorrow?
Exactly.
Right, way to go. Good job.
Just set it on the floor. And then y'all can just sit there.
What are we doing?
Someone come to the set back.
Just won a little game here today.
Yes, yes. Very exciting.
Very excited. So big plans tonight?
Yeah, we're going to celebrate, hopefully, get some food. Yeah, we're really excited.
And then back to work tomorrow?
Yeah, back to work tomorrow. Yep, no days off.
You know who you're playing yet?
I don't actually know. I don't know yet. Yeah.
Neither do I. I haven't heard.
Wednesday, the game. Wednesday. Yes, Wednesday.
We'll be there.
Yes. Thank you.
All right. So this is your second title in 3 years for the division. What do you think?
I think it's a testament to the sub-varsity program. These girls are working hard in the off-season, and they're developing before they get to varsity. So that's where the strength came from. This team is made up of a lot of girls that played on the junior varsity last year. So they're all working really hard. That's why we're having the success right now.
Excellent. So you got to give the girls the night off and back to work tomorrow?
Tomorrow's Sunday? No.
I didn't think so.
We got a day off.
That's fantastic.
Hopkinton went on to the state semifinals. The Hopkinton Hillers handed Amherst their first loss of the season in the Division II state semifinals on Wednesday, November 16th. Hopkinton improved to 21-2 on the season, while the Amherst Hurricanes fell to 23-1. Hopkinton defeated Medway via the sweep, Westboro 3-1, and Canton 3-0 to advance to the state semifinals to take on the West champion Amherst. Amherst went into the semifinals matchup having won every single set except two all season. The Hillers remained in control through the first two sets, taking set one 25-16. Set 2, 25-19. Julia Canestrari lit up the scoreboard in the first two sets, scoring 9 of the Hillers' points. Amherst struck back in the third set and pulled off the win, 25-17.
Unbelievable. Weber, Canestrari's block still alive. The hit over by Gogol, and there it is. The hardest earned point in the history of high school volleyball.
Momentum bounced back and forth throughout the fourth set, but the Hillers went on a late run to close it out, 25-23. Julia Canestrari knocked down the game-winning point for the Hillers.
Number 4, just to recap, the Hillers took set number 1, 25-16. They took set number 2, 25-19. Amherst took set number 3, 25-17. And the Hillers trying to advance to the state finals, but they need 1 point. And Amherst only down by 1. Hayes set to serve, trying to tie the set up. Serve to the back. Set up by Hassan Canestrari, and the Hillers are going to the state finals. Julia Canestrari clinching the victory for the Hillers as they take set number four, 25-23.
The Hopkinton Hillers advance to the state finals to take on South sectional champion Notre Dame Academy, who stands at 21-1. They will meet up Saturday, November 19th at Shrewsbury High School. Notre Dame Academy swept four straight matches to capture the Division II South sectional championship. The 2014 Division II state champion Hopkinton Hillers will play Saturday to try to capture their second state title in the past three seasons.
It is the Amherst Regional Hurricanes against the Hopkinton Hillers. The Hillers 20-2 overall on the season. Amherst is 23-0. What a run it has been for the Hillers to get to the state semifinals, just two wins away from capturing their second state title in the past three seasons. But of course, still a lot of work to do as they meet up with an undefeated Amherst team here this evening. Trying to get the big momentum boost right here. Put the ball in the hands of Ivy Gogolin. To the back line, the dive, and the spike over. That's going to do it. The Hillers take set number one. Jill Sarapusco comes up with the winning point. 25-16 in set number one. The Hillers looking good. Good volley here. Canestrari, Zale. Canestrari with the power to the back. Nicely played by Rice. From the corner, Meller diving for that one to keep it going. Another great volley between these two teams. And there's a great dig by Canestrari. Still alive, and the Hillers get the point. Gogolin getting the last hand on it.
And it's set point now for the Hillers at 24-19.
Set up by Zale. There it is. Hillers take the second set, 25-19. Weber, now Canestrari off of Yath. Nolan sets it up from the corner. There it is, Amherst going to take set number three, 25-17. The Hillers leading 2-1. Serve to the back. Set up by Hassan Canestrari, and the Hillers are going to the state finals. Julia Canestrari clinching the victory for the Hillers as they take set number four, 25-23. The Division II state championship between Notre Dame Academy of Hingham and the Hopkinton Hillers. This should be a fun afternoon of high school volleyball. Both of these teams have just dominated Division II over the last few seasons, and one of these teams today is going to take home the state championship. 20-13 Hillers in set number one. In the back by Howley, the setup. Get over, good dig there by Gilbert, and the hit over for the Hillers, point by Gogolin. Of course, you have the JV team that went undefeated as Miller serves that one up, and that's a Hillers point. Go by Coulter.
In the back. Oh, great dig.
By Gilbert. There it is. Hillers will take it, 25-17. They take set number one, and they dethrone last year's champion Notre Dame Academy Cougars. Bump by Miller. Gilbert.
Oh, nice tap.
Set up in front. Good blocks. Once again, it is Ivy Gogolin.
Gogolin has shut Dwyer down this whole set.
24-18, Hillers. Kelsey Dwyer on the serve into the net. Hillers takes set number two, 25-18, one set away from a state championship. Will the Hillers take home the state championship for the second time in three seasons? Yes, they will! Hopkinton wins as Peyton Weber gets the winning point on the serve, 25-23 in set number three. And your Hopkinton Hillers are the Division II state champions. Unbelievable.
What an ending. What a way to finish that off.
Congratulations to the Hopkinton Hillers. They have claimed their second state championship in the past three seasons and have dethroned the 2015 state champion, Notre Dame Academy Cougars. How you doing?
I'm good, I'm great.
You won the state championship, how does it feel?
It feels amazing. It was so much fun to play in this whole tournament, so it's awesome. It feels so great.
Can you talk about the team this year and just this incredible run? What was it like playing with your teammates?
Oh my, I love my teammates. We had such a good season. We had so much fun together. And I think like the chemistry we had on and off the court just made it such a great team. And we had so much fun. It was awesome.
Well, can you talk about your performance today? You played against a team that also won a couple state championships in the past four seasons. There it is. Hold that up. Hold that up. State champions right here. How you feeling right now?
I'm really excited right now. A lot of emotions.
Well, you played against a great Notre Dame Academy team out there. What did you expect coming into this matchup? Did you think that you were going to get the sweep? Did you think it was going to go five sets? What were your thoughts coming into this tonight?
I expected that it would be a really good game, and we hoped that it would be a sweep, but we didn't know for sure, and we were so excited. We played them 2 years ago and won, so we just really wanted to win again, so it was awesome, yeah.
All right, what comes next? Celebration time?
Yes, lots of celebration, yep.
All right, well, you certainly deserve it. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
How you doing?
Really good right now. I'm so excited.
What was it like playing with this team all season in this run? What's it been like for you?
Incredible. I'm so proud of these girls. We work so hard every day, and I'm so proud of the way how far we came.
How much prep work went into preparing for this great Notre Dame Academy team?
Oh, so much effort. So many hours in the gym, Saturday practices, just working so hard.
Were you nervous at all coming into this afternoon, or did you have confidence that your team is going to go out there and bring home another title?
I was so confident in this team. We were just so awesome. I'm so happy.
What comes next? Celebration time?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Big bus ride home.
I'm sure it's going to be a fun bus ride.
Oh, yeah, lots of screaming.
Well, you certainly earned it. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm feeling pretty good. Stay champs.
Absolutely.
Stay champs.
What's it like to be able to say that you're state champions? Has it really hit you yet?
No, it hasn't. It we couldn't believe that we actually made it this far, and now I can't believe that we actually won. So we're psyched right now.
What's it been like playing with this group all season long?
Oh, it's been amazing.
Yeah, it's been such so a special group.
Yeah, we're all such good friends, and we love playing together. So, yeah.
Any big plans for the celebration?
Hoping for a police escort on the way home, and then we'll probably hang out, get some food.
Absolutely. Well, you certainly deserved it. You must be hungry after playing so hard out there today.
Yes, definitely.
All right, well, go enjoy with your teammates, and congratulations. You're state champions.
Thank you.
How does it feel to be able to say you're a state champion?
It feels great. I mean, we've worked so hard for this. I don't think we could be any happier right now. We are so excited.
You had a tremendous game out there, as did a few of your other teammates as well. What was it like coming into this against this Notre Dame Academy team that's won two state titles recently? Were you nervous at all, or did you feel like your team was ready to go?
I think we were pretty excited. I know we've been doing well the past couple years, and so have they. I heard they've been in the state finals for the past 3 years, so coming in, we knew it was going to be a good game where we could really have a nice matchup, so we were all really excited.
What's it been like playing with this group all season long?
It's the best group of girls. I love everyone on the team. There's no drama, no nothing. We're just all like one big family, so it's been awesome.
Well, I think it's going to be a good bus ride home for you, to say the least.
Very excited for the bus ride.
You're a state champion. Congratulations.
Thank you.
How does it feel to be a state champion?
It feels great. I'm so excited.
What was it like playing with this group all season?
It was awesome. All I have to do is just get to the setter and they do the rest. So.
Now, you played a team today that also recently won a couple state championships. Were you nervous at all going into this matchup, or did you feel like your team was ready?
I think we were prepared. We've been preparing all season, and this is just another game, I feel like.
What comes now? Celebration time?
Oh, yeah. We get the police escort.
Well, congratulations. You certainly earned it. You're a state champion.
Thank you.
Second state championship in 3 seasons. How does it feel?
Who would have thought it, right? It feels great. The girls came into the season with a preseason goal of being state champs. I mean, none of these girls were on that team. 4 of them were pulled up during that team, but none of them were players on that team during the season. But they had the goal. It's a winning tradition in Hopkinton, and they had the talent. It was just such a small, it's a small, close-knit group. So,
what's this group been like to coach?
Such a joy. Such a joy. I mean, this is a smaller roster than I've carried in probably ever. And they were just so close-knit, tight, that it just translated well onto the court. They helped each other out, picked each other up, always kept positive. And it was a pleasure going to practice every single day and showing up for games. And I don't know what I'm going to do. Actually, tomorrow's banquet. I don't know what I'll do on Monday.
What were the practices like coming into this matchup, getting ready for this Notre Dame Academy team that has also won a couple state championships recently?
So we really played it one game at a time. So we were getting ready for Amherst and through Wednesday. So we knew we had 2 days to get ready for NDA. Thank you. And basically, we believed in ourselves, and we know that we're a very well-balanced team, and if we played our game, we've got offensive weapons all over the court. We've got defensive just weapons back there picking up all the hits. They're a very strong team. We knew that coming in, but I think to be the best, you got to beat the best, and we were hoping to be able to see them at some point during the season. So it worked out the way they were hoping, actually. So.
I don't know. How are you feeling right now? You just full of joy or what? You seem like you're about to explode with joy.
I'm so proud. I am so proud. Like, every girl on this team, I'm so happy for the seniors. Like, I'm happy for their accomplishments. I'm happy they were able to reach their goals and to dig deep and, you know, accomplish what they set out to at the beginning of the season. And they're just creating their own legacy. I'm proud. I'm so happy for them.
Well, Coach, another great performance by your team and another great coaching performance by you. Unbelievable job. Congratulations.
Can I give a shout out?
Absolutely.
I think a big, big part of why we were so successful in the postseason was the fan support. Like, we had people in the stands that were just cheering, and it definitely, the girls were playing harder. They were, you know, they wanted to do it for each other, for the coaches, for the school, and for their friends. So that was a big part of it. And the same, like, the sub-varsity coaches and my assistant, Mary Bransfield, like, we wouldn't be where we are without the support that we have. And there's so much talent in Hopkinton, and it's just being modeled by these sub-varsity coaches. So it's easy for me when they come in and they're, you know, from day one, ready to go and saying, we want to win a state championship. You know, that's the confidence and stuff comes from what they're getting at the lower levels. And the administration, too. We got everything we needed to make this a successful season. We were just supported 100%. So, you know, it's nice, but there's a lot of people that, you know, take a part and own this championship.
How about the television coverage that you get? Isn't it wonderful?
Actually, I was going to say, you guys are great. And I had so many people telling me that, you know, if they couldn't make a game that or a match, that they were watching it on TV. And it wasn't just the opposing coaches that was telling me that. It was, you know, a lot of fans that they can't get out. They're able to watch it on TV, and that's important. And thank you so much. We're looking forward.
Well, we enjoy covering the team a lot, and it makes it all the bit sweeter when there's a state championship that you're taking home as well. It makes it even more fun to cover.
You know what? It'll be a fun, loud bus ride, that's for sure. So, thank you.
Well, hopefully there'll be many more state titles and many more fun, loud bus rides. But for now, enjoy this one. You certainly earned it. Congratulations.
Enjoy right now. That's what we're going to do. So, and just reflect upon this amazing season. So, thank you.
There is.
Yeah!
Thank you.
After taking home their second state championship in the past three seasons, Hillers Volleyball hosted their end-of-the-season banquet. The team finished the season 22-2 overall and took home the state championship with a victory over Notre Dame Academy in the championship round. See many more pictures from the banquet at our sceneinhopkinton.org.
Congratulations to the Hopkinton Hillers girls volleyball team and head coach Margie Grabmeier on another unbelievable season that will go down as one of the greatest runs in Hopkinton Hillers athletics history. That will just about do it for this edition of HCAM News Focus. Don't forget to stay up to date with everything Hopkinton by checking out our website, hcam.tv, as well as our Twitter and Facebook page. If there is a photo, video, or story idea you would like to share with us, feel free to email me at news@hcam.tv. With your help, we'll cover even more of our community. For everyone here at HCAM, I'm Tom Nappy. Thank you for watching.